All right, now that we've got the wonderful technical issues out of the way, welcome back for another Icarus Beta Weekend number 3 with Bad ET. This weekend we're doing the Arctic. Apparently it's going to be nice and fun, and so much that with the nice little Steam update that they put out, this is what it says. The Arctic has been the most anticipated biome from our community. It's home to a mammoth, polar bears, wolves, its own weather events like blizzards, and ice caves. Yes, that's right, ice caves. It says, don't just run there, prepare. You've landed in your dropship, and the door opens into the forest biome. You step outside and look for the closest point of entry to the Arctic. You're so excited and start running there. It says, hold on, Prospector, there are a few things you should do first. Collect resources and get crafting. Just like previous beta weekends, you will be presented with the same challenges as soon as you set foot on Icarus. Do what you've done best and chop down trees, hunt, build a cabin, and craft necessities such as weapons and fur armor to prepare for your expedition into the cold. Then determine your prospector's life-threatening needs. While the forest biome is sufficient with freshwater lakes and oxite, the Arctic is not. Craft and fill water skin and oxygen bladder so you can top up when needed while you're in the Arctic. You can find ice scattered across the snowy ground and melt them down into water by using a campfire, which will subsequently fill your water skin. Having an ample amount of food to satiate your hunger until your first Arctic hunt would also be smart. I'll work on my verbiage. And number 3, bring supplemental resources with you. Once you're in the thick of the Arctic, having the ability to build a cabin for shelter midway to your final destination can save your life. Carry extra wood or refined materials and other crafting benches or tables that can fit into your inventory without sacrificing your weight or other important items. If you're playing in a group, try dispersing these items among your team. In the case that you fall short of resources, caves make great safe havens and host an array of ore. So this beta weekend's open. It looks like they've pretty much doubled the map with having the Arctic biome as well as the previous beta weekend 1 and 2 areas open. They say all prospects have been cleared according to patch notes. Characters who were on drops have been returned to the station ready to head to new prospect with their current talent and skills unlocked, intact. Buildings constructed on cliff faces will no longer destroy themselves when players reload into the prospect. Animals will no longer try to path through dropships. When placing a full oxygen tank into a hotbar slot, it will now fill the player's oxygen to 100%. Left-clicking the oxygen tank in the hotbar now consumes oxygen. Lightning can no longer destroy items inside caves. Arrows will no longer duplicate when they are recovered from skinned corpses. Players can no longer be struck by lightning while inside a house. Logged-out players no longer show as dead prospector. Logged out players no longer show as a dead marker on the map. Players no longer fall through the world when reloading their prospect into a cave. Animals can no longer attempt to pass through cave voxel coverings. Animal corpses now despawn after 10 minutes. Animal corpses no longer respawn when the player reloads into the prospect. Repaired building pieces, floor, wall, beams, etc., can now also stack with newly crafted building pieces inside the player's inventory. We'll see what that's all about. Rifle rounds now break on hit. Okay. And then a couple of quality of life updates with modular kitchens and functional gardens. We also deployed quality of life adjustments among our developers. We enforced a relative stand down to those who work longer hours over beta weekend 2. If it wasn't for their hard work, the massive hot fixes and updates we pushed through would have not been possible. As a side, this means that the amount of bug fixing between beta weekends was limited, but we are more than happy with the results we have achieved. Well, with a well-rested team, you can report bugs, of course. Back to HTTPS, Icarus.featureupvote.com. So, all right, so that is the updates. So we'll get started. First, building our little forest biome first, and then take off and move towards the Arctic. And hopefully we'll be up there with all of our new stuff and get started. So again, this is about ET. Thanks for joining, and hope you enjoy the wonderful third beta weekend with the Arctic. All right, so see, they left me with my wonderful little level 24 from last time, which I was just right around the corner once I found out that I was like, oh, I should have kept going. I didn't know that we were gonna be keeping our characters. Of course, that's who we are, and our prospects. Time is a counting. Let's-a go.
Sample. So they need you to head to the Arctic and bring down a mammoth. Yeah, you heard me. Get them something to study. But the Arctic's tough, and the mammoth's even tougher. You'll need more than sharp sticks. Think you can handle that?
Okay, so this weekend they've chosen to give us a objective of retrieving a mammoth tusk from the Arctic, incomplete. And then we have to bring it back, apparently. So Arctic is under surveyed, so teams will be dropped into map areas, then trek into the region to locate a target. Harvesting samples will require metal tools at a minimum. This contract is rated moderate risk with medium to strong storm, blizzards, and very limited support planet side. All right. Your 15 bio sample. All right, let's roll it. It's a level up, cool. 18 talent points, 56 blueprint points. Oh yeah, that's right. At level 25, they were unlimited last time. Oh, come down. Look, no trees. Let's go. It's different. Interesting.
Something that size. Never underestimate Icarus. Not if you want to live. Good luck, friend.
Okay. I see, he's still as friendly as always. Better you than me. Mentality. As always, just start collecting. Well, we do have a bunch of talent points to play and catch up for. Sticks and stones, sticks and stones. At least it dropped me next to water this time. Last weekend it dropped me a couple of grid squares away from water. So that didn't exactly make it fun. Kept dying within about 50 minutes after once I got set. I burned down my first house by walking through the fire. I don't recommend that. And as you can tell by the bar in the top left corner, definitely have some XP to make up to get to 25, which that's all right. Not much. It's part of the learning. But last time they didn't allow us to keep it, so this time, at least we do. So as you can tell, we've pretty much cleaned up the hillside with everything that we can just by grabbing our what we can walk around with. Not too much food, water. We got water right there. And there's some oxide behind us. And since we know what we can craft, and we kind of did a speed run on our last episode for last beta weekend, we kind of already know what we're doing. We just have to find the caves for the section that we're at and be able to craft a recurve bow without dying and start working our way towards the Arctic biome and retrieving that tusk. Now, they did mention that the developers, or at least some of the other streamers, that they were going to make it so that there's not as many animals counteractions or interactions between running around and running all through your bases and everything. So, we'll see if it still works again also with mining into the rocks during the weather storms if it protects you. We'll see if that works up with the Arctics or not. I mean, they did mention the ice caves, so they also mentioned they did a dehumidifier because they did 4 patch updates during the last beta weekend, which made for some technical difficulties on my end. Forward to trying everything out again. This is the third beta weekend. The first one was the forest biome, the second one was a little bit more forest biome. And now, this one is the Arctic biome. Well, they actually did storms last week, and they included the storms, so that was the main thing that they wanted to do last weekend. Get you used to it and bring in the storms. Now you get to explore to the Arctic, although they did open up some of the Arctic and desert last beta day or so, since so many of us were actually exploring out and finding them by accident. They did a few updates for that so we didn't get stopped dying so quickly with it. We're way over here. Okay. Not a problem. That is 4 squares over last time. J14. Okay. Let's see how this goes. They're burying them in the rocks a little bit more. Okay. I didn't experience that with my other beta weekends. Okay. Let's go ahead and set up shop, get everything built, prepare. See what we could do with exploring. All right, I think we're gonna build here. Definitely consuming berries helps with the water food consumption. All right, tech tree, what do we have going on here? I'm a little confused, I'm not gonna lie. Did I level up or something? 10 points available and we'll find out more. Let's see. Well, since we're going to more combat. Spears, spear, and spears. Yeah, definitely need to work on my weight capacity. Not too sure about that so far. Right. Just never bury a friend. Touche. Okay. Or torch with torch. With rank torch. I see what they did here. Okay, I have to come on, hold off. Oh, no, I need the canteen. C25 should be up there. Canteen. There's that's working, huh? Okay. All right, we're gonna hold off there for now. Do everything else. Ooh. Okay, we're just gonna hold off there. Over here. What do we need to make? What? Wood. We need wood. Okay, no problem. Take that. Grab that. Grab those. This guy. Grab the bandage. I'm gonna get that. That'll work. Okay. Now. Oh, look. I think they added colors. I don't know. Let's go to town. Go mess some things up. Actually, one second. Settings, gameplay. Pretty, huh? Nope, not gonna do that. Go back. Okay. Much better. Let's go. Wasted 3 hours doing our tech points, but that's okay. Oh, look, my first visitor. That's so nice. Oh, look, they brought company. Really? What is that? Okay, that was a waste. And there we have it. First shelter, Beta Weekend 3. Yeah, maybe. Just a simple little shelter. Guess I've been going. Enough room to get in. Get everything set. Yeah, you know what? Let's grab one of those. I like having that. Really accessible. Alright. Hunt down wolves. Not really. Oxygen. What else? Water. Water skin thermos. Canteen. All right, and back to the shopping. Make some fire. Ooh, oxygen. What? I always need wood. What does it cost to make a bed? Bed. Fur and leather. Okay. That one. I like how you're able to repair on the go instead of having to go all the way back to the crafting. As long as you got whatever materials that they're requiring, I didn't pay attention if it took the soul of your body to craft it all. Normally it removes all your stamina. I always like putting that thing up there. It's always fun. Alright, this is our clothing bench. This is what we're going to use to craft our wonderful fur, all of our fur stuff for the Arctic. Oh, we'll get to that. I found that doing a lot of your work in the beginning of your prospect, even at night instead of sleeping, seems to be more beneficial rather than taking the shortcut and getting through the night and coming through the day. Just want to maximize what you can. we have? Get that tree sap. So we'll be needing that for that boy. Lots of it. All right. It's getting light out again. That's good. Damn, where's it gonna be? Okay, so I get the steel stuff going. It goes a little quicker. Makes up that there's water over there. Now, I'm not sure if it gave me a reading last time for the stones. I know it did for the oxides, but overall, the stone? I'm not sure. That's fine. Let's take one ore. And all your stamina. Okay, no problem. Thank you. What are they doing? All right, we'll get some more fur. There we go, that's what we like to see. Hold on. Oh, really? That's all right. I like stabbing the piranhas. Give you plenty of XP real quick. Because with the skinning bench, you get more items out of it. So, might as well craft it and set it up since you have parts for it. Alright. Now let's go ahead and start stacking our room. I think we want to put the fireplace. I think we'll expand out one more. Throw the fireplace up right there. Or, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, something like that. Okay. And if you make everything close enough, you can actually sit here and just turn, swap, do it. Ascension and sulfur. Okay, so that's loaded. You only need 32 to consume. Alright, split stack, left ship, boom. Save that stack. Put that back, okay. Sulfur. I need to find some sulfur. Brutal. What happened to F take all? They took that option away. Oh, look, some sulfur. What happened there? Where are we? Ooh, cool. Look at that. This little biome. A biome? What am I saying? It's a cave. It's ore. Oh, yeah. All right. I take notes. I write down where I find stuff so that I can try to remember how to get there next time. Follow the river home. Oof. Talk about some hustle and bustle to make some stuff. Huh. Alright. And there and there. And look at it. Creates. Alright. What we got to do. Let's get rid of the skin bench. Where do we want to put? Yes, put it over here. All right, that should have got rid of some weight. Now we have oxygen on the go. And then you're gonna... All right. So we'll have that. Okay, did you work on that? Walls. It's a two-story base. Already? 300 XP for a fell tree, huh? Hold up. All right. Alright, so last time, this just replaces the window outside Always got to remember to at least set a bed and set your respawn point, or else it'll drop you back in on a drop pod, but it just makes it a bit more difficult. So that would be my recommendation. We're all set for a spawn point. Good to go. All right. Those done. Follow the river. All right, we're just gonna take a quick break real quick before we continue on with searching for more iron. So we'll be right back with more from Icarus.